know how to start this motherfucker. I'm just pulling up to the crib, man. I just got me a 12-pack. Shit. I'm finna pull up. I'm finna set this motherfucker up. And it's throwing some change day. Fuck that. Breaking my motherfucking whatever I got going on, and we on it. You know what I'm saying? Cause I be in my motherfucking head so much, I'm finna cut this shit off. Like, fuck it. But
4&Somechange podcast, episode 2. Really, episode 1. You feel me? So, subscribe to my page. Subscribe to my channel. Follow me on Instagram. Follow me on YouTube. Shoot. 4&Somechange podcast. Hop in the booth and let the truth be told. I'm not a stripper, but I gotta keep a pole. They got a baby now, just to get her clothes. Alright, what up, y'all?
What? Second podcast we got down.
Blueface, baby.
Why do y'all know?
Yeah, I was down, I had to hit the studio. I was down, I hit the studio. Hop in the booth and let the truth be told. I'm not a stripper, but I gotta keep a pole. They gotta pay me now just to get up close. When I was down, I hit the studio. Hop in the booth and let the truth be told. I'm not a stripper, but I gotta keep a pole. They gotta pay me now just to get up close.
Niggas looking up to me like I made it. I was down, you ain't caring, I'm up, and they hate it. I hate it. But I had to be patient. Anything I did, I had to be the greatest. Only one who faced is I'm...
I was recording, well, I planned on recording as soon as I got home earlier. Crazy thing. As soon as I pulled out my camera, motherfucking spring came out of my camera, so that really blew me. That blew me for a minute. So I took a couple drinks, and I got lit. But I got a headache. There's been this new incense in this bitch, and the incense was just burning like a motherfucker. And that shit was giving me a headache, you feel me? Shit, I ate and I fucking passed out on some crazy shit. Feel me? But I'm up now, shit. So I'm about to get this motherfucker recorded. You know what I'm saying? Forgot what song I'm fucking with. I'm listening to this Blueface like a motherfucker. The studio, this shit been riding. I ain't even gonna stitch up. But that's been chilling today. I'm sitting back washing clothes, man. I was just thinking, like, damn, like, a nigga really be washing clothes. like faithfully. Like, you know what I'm saying? Oh, and I had a question, too. I want to, alright, so, to pop it off, this is the first thing I want to ask. Alright, debate, you feel me? Like, and I want to keep it all the way G, you feel me? So, let's keep it G. Alright. How many times do y'all change y'all sheets? How many times do you change the sheets? You feel me? Like, I want to know. Like, I want to know. How many times do you change the sheets? Like, you feel me? Because motherfuckers be lying. Like, I know it. Like, you ain't got to tell me. Like, I know y'all be lying. You feel me? But I want to know. I'm washing clothes in the background too, so it might be a little staticky or something. But so yeah, I wanted to ask that question. So how many times do you guys change y'all sheets? Because I don't know. I ain't gonna start. I've been to a couple few months' houses, and I could tell by the way kind of motherfuckers don't be changing their sheets like that. And I don't know what to say about that, but I just wanted to ask y'all, so y'all let me know in the comments when the last time what do you think? Like, even like an oil change, motherfucker, supposed to get your oil change every what, 3,000 miles or something like that, lovely, lovely. So shit, with your sheets, nigga, what should you be changing them all? I mean, I sweat a lot in my sleep, so shit. I usually wash my sheets and my blankets, comforters, probably like at least once a week, Probably, no, I ain't gonna flex. Probably like once every 2 weeks, you know what I'm saying? Probably like once a month if I'm being lazy as a fuck, like I ain't eating. You feel me? But it got to happen though, because I sweat a lot when I sleep, bro. That was really why I was asking, because I feel like I'd be washing my sheets and stuff a lot. And I don't really see a lot of people washing their sheets, usually. When they say they're washing clothes, but I don't know. I might be tripping, so y'all let me know on that part. But other than that, this 4&Somechange podcast got down. I got a couple homies I want to bring around, and, you know, we just sit back and talk. Sit back and exchange and get things off our chest, you feel me? And have a more, it's a conversation between our generation, you know. I'm 26, I don't think I told you guys. 26, we're from Savannah. I don't have a job, I'm unemployed, I do music. I edit videos a little bit, graphic design a little bit. I'm not a master at anything yet, and I'm not afraid to, you know, admit it. But I am working at it, and I've been working at it. And this is another step to help me buckle down and take my career seriously. But I'm a big music head. Like, I love music like to death. So I jam, like, that's all I do. I don't watch TV, unless I'm watching the games, you know, a little bit. Other than that, I just listen to music and watch YouTube videos, and I'm inspired by other podcasts that I watch. That's it. So I'm really a big music head, man. Like, on my phone, all I got is just music apps. Like, that's all I do, is to listen to whatever drops new. Like, of course, I got the Apple Music, SoundCloud, Blackpill, Spinrilla, my mixtapes. Everything that about music, I'm pretty much on it. So, and I'm a big music head. So, I do want to have, like, reviews and extra stuff like that, because I listen to a lot of artists that I feel like that don't get a lot of recognition, or just people that just have good music in general, because I mean, I just like good music. I'm a fan of real good music. And, you know, that's just me. And when I think about that too, it's just like, when I like good music, like catchy melodies and stuff like that. And I also like to listen to music that makes you sit down and think also. But as far as in my music, like, I got a lot of good catchy music, but I feel like I need more of that good sit down music that you can just reflect to also. So look forward for that too, because I plan on working on some more music with I guess more serious content. Like, I'm very good at, you know, being very real in my music about what I'm going through, but I kind of want it to be more serious versus popular music, you know, like, dancing and stuff. Which is nothing wrong with that, because I can do that, but this time around, I want something that's more, as I got older, I want something that's more, you know, more serious. So I'm working on that too. So this 4&Somechange podcast, you know, this is just the second episode, basically the first one, because the other one I dropped, it was just 0.5, because it wasn't really what I wanted to be, but I was filling it out. I was testing the groove and figure out how I wanted to do it. So this is the step closer to it. So yeah, man, that's basically it, man. Like, I don't know. I just gotta get way more comfortable behind this camera and you know, things of that nature. So, I've just been, I'm watching the games, you know, the Lakers, I'm watching the Lakers, I'm liking OKC. I really like the 76ers. It's looking real good. I mean, I'm just ready for the finals, you know. So it's gonna be exciting to watch. As far as in football, I don't know. I'm a big Jaguars fan. It's hard to tell you why, or even, you know, I mean, we can just leave it at that. I mean, it just, you know, football's football. Like, but that's something that you say when your team be losing all the time. You just be like, you know, I just watch the game, bro. It don't really matter to me who wins, bro. Like, it don't matter, bro. That shit still, like, you know what I'm saying? Maybe next year, bro. But whatever. Something that you might not need on a regular basis or something. Or let me just say this. Alright. So one time I went to someone's house and I got hurt. I cut myself. And I needed some Neosporin or something like that to put on my hand. And I asked my friend to get some for me. He got it for me. I checked the expiration date on it. Said 2003. It's 2018, man. Like, what's going on? You feel me? Like, I done went to another homie house. Like, I had like a little slight headache or something. I was like, hey, bro, you got some Advil or something? Something I can take? He's like, yeah, bro, I got some medicine for you real quick. Hold on, I'll be right back. Boom, came back with the medicine. Boom, appreciate it, bro. Hold on, let me check the expiration date. 2010. What's up with all this old stuff y'all be trying to pass out? Like, start checking your expiration dates. Go on your cabinets, go on your medicine cabinets, go on your covers, go on your drawers, whatever you need to do. Start checking your expiration dates. Like, I know it's been there for a minute. Shoot, it's still good. It might be, no. Get rid of it, bro. Please. Don't be giving people that stuff. Like, what, would you use it? Do you use it? Don't give it to me. That's all I want to say on that. Just check your expiration dates, because this is ridiculous. Like, we just too old. We using that old ass shit. Like, we know better now. Like, you know better, you do better. Throw that in the trash. Shit is ridiculous. For real. Another question for today. It dawned on me the other day. So I was thinking, like, so would you rather have a girl with no car and a job, or a girl with a car and then going on bus up? Much ain't got shit going on, she just got a car. That's it. No money, she'll pull up. She can't do shit for you. She's in the way. But she there though. She on the way, in the way. Or a motherfucker with no car, with a job. Let me know, man. I don't know. I mean, it's not like it matters, but, you know. I was there. Because, honestly, I'm a nigga with no job in a car. So, you can think how you want to. But, I just want to know. What would you rather have? What do you, I don't know. It's a little, something I've been thinking about. Yeah. Oh yeah, man, I had took some shots of Fireball earlier. That's what it was. I meant to tell you. I think I said it in the voice memo, but I didn't say what I was sipping because I was actually already throwed. Yeah. That's what set the nigga off, and I took me straight to sleep. You know what I mean? And then that shit blew me about that camera. Like, well, as soon as I was finna set up, I said, alright, I'm finna set up. And get shit right, feeling motivated, boom. And get in the house, I'm finna set this shit up. Nigga put a camera out, fucking spring pop out that bitch. I'm like, oh, what the fuck? I'm like, oh, man, nigga already hungry. I'm already sipped out, you feel me? So I'm like, now, hold on, let me get right. I'm like, all right, hold on, let me try to find this shit real quick. Can't find the screw. I'm looking all over this bitch. So I'm like, right here, now I'm looking all over the screw. I got the light on, looking all over the screw, you feel me? Pops come in this bitch, he's trying to help me look for the screw. I'm like, bro, I don't know where to put this shit at. You feel me? He like, this shit probably over here somewhere. I'm like, man. At this point, I'm just like, bro, I'm blowing. I'm just like, all right, for sure, man. When I start saying for sure, when I just be like, when I don't say nothing else, I just be like, for sure, man. Nigga blow. like, I ain't blow, but I'm fed up. Like, it's over. Like, but it is what it is. When I say for sure like that, I be like, for sure, man. For sure. That nigga fed up. So that's what that mean. You feel me? So once I started saying that shit, I was like, damn. So that shit really sweet blew me. So shit. Nigga drunk another brew, goddamn. Shit, I was already, about three brews in there and shit. Nigga had about two little shooters of that Fireball shit. Bitch, I was lit. Shit, it don't take me much, goddamn. Shit, and nigga been firing up that, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, so why I did that, man, I'm sending you. Man, shit, that motherfucking candle at that bitch, whatever that little incense shit was, that shit started fuming up real quick. That bitch gave a nigga a headache. Wow, that bitch came quick, cuz I'm talking about quick. Oh shit, let me goddamn lay my ass down for a little minute. A little minute turned into about the whole night, nigga. I'm like, oh shit. When nigga woke up, like, damn, boy, I'm tripping again. Yeah, I go with this bullshit, scared of the camera and shit. Fuck that. I'm about to pull this bitch out. What's going on? You feel me? I'm about to drop me some today. Goddamn it. Feeling some motherfucking change today. Scared up with the washing machine in the back and all. Like, fuck that. I don't care. Fuck that. I'm doing something today. I have to. I got to stay motivated. I got to keep doing something. I got to stay on my motherfucking Jesus. I be my own motherfucker. I be beating my own self. You feel me? Nigga, shit ridiculous. I got moves to be making, and I'm fucking my own self up. You feel me? I'm shooting my own self in the foot. Fuck that. Like, nah, not no more. 4&Somechange, you feel me? So, I'm gonna end this with, I didn't learn much today. You feel me? I want to say, every episode has like something about that I learned or something like that, but let me take that back. I did learn something today because my brother called me and I should stay with my other brother. I just moved back in with my people, so it's kind of, well, my pop, so it's kind of, you know, trying to get my shit together, you feel me? Like, in the midst of my shit was already fucked up, so I'm trying to fix shit. But anyway, long story short, my brother called me today and my homeboy just moved in with him, and just remember this mile, like, he was deeper than the homeboy. I call him, like, my folk, bro. Like, as bros, me and him came up together, like, for real, like best friends, actually. So, he moved in with my big brother today, so he was telling me, like, the people he was staying with, They're like family too, but they've been getting into it. So, long story short, he moved in with my brother. Shit been going crazy. So, I just told my brother, like, I wanted him to make sure that he understand that even though we've been through a lot with just me and him, you know, in life, and he hasn't always been the leader that I wanted him to be, he has a chance now to redeem himself, and I want him to understand that. So hopefully, you know, he took what I said to him into consideration, because I do believe people are coming to him now as a big brother, as someone that can help and lead by example, and I want to be that too. So I just, you know, I'm just glad that I could talk to him today about that. And, you know, I just learned that, you know, sometimes the roles can change, you know, and you have to allow that. So that's all I learned. That's just to, you know, cap that up on the 4&Somechange, what I learned, or the lesson for the day. So, yeah, man. Thank y'all for watching, you know. Thank y'all for, you know, supporting me, for actually, you know, staying on my back, staying on my neck, you feel me? Like, staying on my heels, like, making sure I actually do something. I appreciate y'all for calling me, people that have been checking up on me lately. I take everything, I'm grateful for all of it, you know. I really appreciate it, so. Thank you, guys. Make sure to follow me on Instagram and continue to watch me elevate, you know. And watch us elevate, because without y'all, there would be no me. So I appreciate you guys. And I guess I'm going to figure out what song that I like the most, that I've been feeling. I'm probably going to let y'all listen to all of you. What song that I like? I ain't gonna stop listening to that Meek album, that Meek Mill album, like, fuck, but, I don't know, I want something. I played that Blueface at the beginning, that studio, so I wanna play something more, synthy, because I like R&B too. So probably gonna play, this Neither Do I, featuring Jeremiah. Let that ride out for a little minute, and then, yeah. Appreciate y'all. Yeah.
Let's peace. Take off the top, go hit the club.
Hola.
Do you know what it feels like to fall in love? Take off the top, ready to fuck. Yeah. Do you know what it feels like to fall in love, girl? Neither do I. I say we find out. Cover your eyes. Well, go turn the lights out. I know you want it from the way you like to move, girl. Why you frontin' like you ain't got nothing to lose, girl? Yeah. I'm just trying to make a move, girl. Got you in the new, girl. Yeah. I remember days when this wouldn't go the same. Before I was famous, it's true, we out here chasing bitches. Now I'm done with that. I came up and now I'm rich. I got some wrong with that. But you different than these women. Got me coming back. Can't let anybody have you. Can't have none of that. Yeah. Let's take off the top. Go hit the club.